Good evening. Welcome to the St. Brendan's Parish community, and a special welcome to any visitors who are joining us today. My name is Colleen DeMarco, and I will be proclaiming the readings today. Today, we celebrate the 32nd Sunday in Ordinary Time. There are a few announcements. Seniors will meet this Monday in the hall at Newfane. Members are asked to bring a one-pound package of pasta to be donated to our local food pantries. Eucharistic Adoration will be this Monday from 4 to 7 p.m. in Newfane. Once again, the Outreach Committee will put up an angel tree to help our shut-ins, those who've lost a loved one this past year, and also helping a family who might need assistance this Christmas season. Envelopes will be on the tree to take for a donation. Please return in the collection no later than December 17th. Your kindness is greatly appreciated. Our celebrant today is Father Matt Mitch. Please rise.
Our opening hymn this evening, number 320, The King Shall Come, number 320.
In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
And welcome all parishioners and guests and visitors to us today, and especially any veterans coming to be with us today. We thank you for your services. We honor your sacrifices. It is Jesus Christ who invites us to come into communion with him in this Eucharist, the heavenly banquet. We acknowledge that we are not ready, that we are saints in the making. We need God's grace, forgiveness, healing, and so we ask for his mercy. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You sit at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest.
Oh,
to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest. And on earth all of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, graciously keep us from all adversity, so that unhindered in mind and body alike, we may pursue in freedom of heart the things that are yours. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns within the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. Resplendent and unfading is wisdom, and she is readily perceived by those who love her and found by those who seek her. She hastens to make herself known in anticipation of their desire. Whoever watches for her at dawn shall not be disappointed, for he shall find her sitting by his gate. For taking thought of wisdom is the perfection of prudence, and whoever for her sake keeps vigil shall quickly be free from care. Because she makes her own rounds, seeking those worthy of her, and graciously appears to them in the ways, and meets them with all solicitude. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. O God, you are my God, whom I seek. For you my flesh pines and my soul thirsts. Like the earth parched, lifeless and without water, my soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. Thus have I gazed toward you in the sanctuary, to see your power and your glory. For your kindness is a greater good than life, my lips shall glorify you. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. I bless you while I live. Lifting up my hands, I will call upon your name. As with the riches of a banquet, must shall my soul be satisfied. And with exalted lips, my mouth shall praise you. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. I will remember you upon my couch, and through the night watches I will meditate on you. You are my help, and in the shadow of your wings I shout for joy. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with a word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
With you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. The foolish ones, when taking their lamps, brought no oil with them, but the wise brought flasks of oil with their lamps. Since the bridegroom was long delayed, they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight, there was a cry, "Behold the bridegroom, come out to meet him." Then all those virgins got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish ones said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise ones replied, "No, for there may not be enough for us and you. Instead, go to the merchants and buy some for yourselves." While they went off to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went into the wedding feast with him. Then the door was locked. Afterwards, the other virgins came and said, "Lord, Lord, open the door for us." But he said in reply, "Amen, I say to you, I do not know you. Therefore, stay awake, For you know neither the day nor the hour. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Stay awake, be prepared, be ready, for we don't know when things will come, when we have to be ready for anything. We read Buffalo News just recently, there was a couple of articles, comments that the Buffalo Council is still not exactly ready for next storm to come. They're still kind of making final determinations and plans. And luckily, there was no October surprise that way. But we know that some kind of a winter event will be coming because it's Buffalo and it's winter. Today's gospel reading is a parable, a story about helping us to prepare ourselves, be ready for the groom's coming. And we don't know when. We know that this is the coming to the end of the liturgical cycle, and therefore we have readings talking about coming of Christ, the second coming, the end of the world, and then of course when we get into Advent, closer to Christmas, there will be first coming, Christmas, but this is about closer like the second coming. So Christ is coming into our lives now. Not necessarily when he comes back again, but even now as we speak, Christ wants to come into our lives. Today's gospel parable, it's a parable, it's a story. A story taken from life, usually people could relate to it with a twist that people would like stop and think like, what did he mean by it? So a story about a wedding and wedding customs. Usually a groom would be spending that evening before the wedding night negotiating with two families, kind of negotiating about who gives what to for the wedding. And usually it was taking some time, sometimes even till midnight. And so the wedding party, the brides and attendants will have to wait. And usually it was late at night and it was dark and there was no electricity, so they had little olive lamps and olive oil was expensive. So they would kind of keep them, maybe one of them lit just in the middle of the room, and some of them became drowsy and fell asleep. And out of 10 of them, five came prepared for anything. They brought extra oil with them, just in case, never know. And the other five were basically unprepared for, they thought, well, if anything wrong happens, if we need them, we can always ask for help, and I'm sure someone will help. And that may be kind of surprising to us that the supposedly wise ones said to the foolish ones, sorry, we cannot give you any oil, we cannot share the oil with you. Well, how Christian is that? You have it, moment of need, and you will not share it. Well, that's one of those surprises of the parable, makes us think. Now, the story is a parable, which means there is allegorical meaning, deeper meaning to it. So, of course, what do we mean by the oil? The light of the Holy Spirit. What fuels the lamp is the wisdom of God, is our openness to accept God's Holy Spirit in us, in our daily lives. And some people are wise or wiser that way, and others kind of sort of do some other things, thinking, well, if the time comes, then I can always ask for help, maybe, and ask for directions, so to speak, at the last moment, which may not happen. We may not have enough time, or there may not be properly disposed people in our midst to be willing to help us. The oil is the guidance of the Holy Spirit and also the good deeds that result from the guidance and our following the will of God. Because if we believe, then we have to live it. And we live it, then it results in us doing God's will, doing what's right in the eyes of God, following the commandments, and so on and so forth. So that's something we have to do individually. And that's the reason that the wise virgins, attendants would not share, because they couldn't. Not that they wouldn't want to, they just couldn't. It's a personal experience. We come to experience God coming to us personally. And we do so usually through sacraments. That's the usual way when Jesus comes to us in the Catholic Church. Sacraments are the visual signs of the invisible presence of Christ, affecting the presence of Christ. And it has to be experienced individually. We cannot receive a sacrament on behalf of someone else. We cannot be baptized on behalf of someone else. We cannot receive Holy Communion on behalf of someone else who may be sick at home and would like to do it, but we cannot do it. We cannot go to confession on behalf of someone else, though so many people try. We cannot receive confirmation on behalf of someone else. It's an individual, personal experience of Christ. And that's what we try to do. So Jesus invites us all to be ready for his coming. He's coming to us right now in the Eucharist, but also he's coming to us throughout of our lives through events and circumstances and people we meet. Sometimes we wonder, well, why these things happen to me? You know, why bad things happen to good people? Why did someone said something to me? Maybe it's guidance. Maybe it's the reason for it. Maybe it was not meant to be. Maybe God knows something better is coming to me. Therefore, I was prevented from this thing to happening to me or coming to me. It's a great mystery. Ultimately, God knows. And ultimately, we are all called to join the wedding feast. What's the wedding feast? It's a heavenly supper of the Lamb in heaven. And each Eucharist, each Mass, is a little glimpse of it, like a taste of heaven. That's what happens. Book of Revelation speaks of the supper of the Lamb. It's a heavenly wedding feast. Who's the groom? Well, Jesus is. God. If God is the groom, who's the bride? The church is. The church is the bride of Christ. Who's the church? Well, that would be us. Every single one of us, we are the attendants at the wedding. And so we are asked to be ready because we don't know when the groom will come. And so he may, if we're not ready, if we, our light will go out, then we may not find a way to enter the kingdom. So what keeps our light going? Well, the Holy Spirit in our souls, in our hearts. How do we keep this Holy Spirit in us? We invite the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is a gentleman. He does not force his way into us. We have to invite him. We've received the Holy Spirit at our baptism, all the gifts, seven gifts, all of them at baptism. Confirmation sealed the gifts, so we have them strengthened and elevated now. And if we live the gifts, obey the commandments, follow the way of Beatitudes, follow the golden rule, do works of charity, mercy, compassion, good deeds, spiritual, corporal, then the Holy Spirit will be manifesting through us. And clearly we'll kind of get help and guidance which way to go. So it's a beautiful parable, a challenging a bit maybe, but ultimately very hopeful because we are all not only called to be part of the wedding feast, we already partake in it through Eucharist. We don't have to wait till heaven to be with Jesus we already partake in communion with God in this life. Amazing! That's how much God loves us. Keep on a journey of faith, we rise and we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, all this is visible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ. Man for our salvation. He came down from heaven
by the Holy Spirit, incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man.
For our sake, he was crucified by Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. Rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures, ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, whom the Father and the Son adored and glorified. He has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. People on the journey of faith, we present our prayers and petitions to our loving Heavenly Father, asking Him to answer them according to His holy will.
For the Church, that we may exercise wisdom in preparing for the Lord's coming into our hearts and at the end of time, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That as residents of this planet, we may exercise our wisdom to see the sign of climate change around us and work to lessen the consequences of global warming. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our parish community may have the generosity to assist those who may suffer and who are in need during this upcoming winter season, especially the homeless and those that are hungry. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For veterans, living and deceased, for the great sacrifices that they made to keep our country safe. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, and religious life, especially in the Diocese of Buffalo. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those struggling with illnesses and recovering from surgeries, especially Todd Busing, Michael and Janice Suchewiki, Cindy Chapman, Jason Barry, Maureen Fraunapple, and Arlen Jenkins. That our Blessed Mother may comfort, console, and help them to find inner joy amid their challenges. Let us pray to the Lord. For all the faithfully departed, especially Hugh Morgan, father of Deacon Howard Morgan, that the Good Shepherd may welcome them into the peace of heaven, and especially for Paul Harder, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here today, and for our prayers and intentions that we bring before the Lord, let us pray to the Lord.
Heavenly Father, we give you thanks and we ask you to bless us. Help us with your Holy Spirit to always choose what is right, good, and beautiful. Help us to always follow your holy will through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please join our hymn during the offertory, number 615, Seek Ye First, number 615.
Sisters and brothers, and my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, upon the sacrificial gifts offered here, that celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with loving devotion through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that the people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit might, to the praise of your manifold wisdom, be manifest as the church. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, bread of life, and a chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, in prayer to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Michael our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Confidence, we know prayers Jesus himself has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant for peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Offer each other a sign of peace. God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
For those unable to attend Mass in person to receive the Eucharist, I invite you to pray an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
Please join in our hymn during the communion, number 702, The Love of the Lord, number 702.
Let us pray. Lord, by this sacred gift, O Lord, we give you thanks and beseech your mercy, that by the pouring forth of your Spirit, the grace of integrity may endure in those your heavenly power has entered through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Once again, we acknowledge and thank all any and all veterans in our midst and those who couldn't come in our families, those we know, those who sacrificed their lives, and those who continue to keep us safe now.
Today I was not able to hear confessions before Mass because I was coming from previous Mass in Ransomville. So if there's anyone who wants to go to confession today, I'll be in the confessional now after Mass. So that's an opportunity to grow in wisdom that way by receiving the sacrament of reconciliation. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. And our closing hymn tonight, number 520, All the Ends of the Earth, number 520. John, how you doing?